What is happening, everybody? Trey here, joined by my dad, Sean. And today, reactions to the classics. We have another Eurovision song battle. And it's going to be our Turkish Eurovision battle part two, man. Our first Turkish video has been unbelievable. Over 40,000 views.
That's one of our top 10 videos on this channel. We have almost 1,400 videos up. It's insane.
Yeah, so we needed some more Turkey videos. And our patron and a big Eurovision fan of the channel, John, suggested this one for us to do. So I'm looking forward to it. We have Sebnem Paker's track,
Dinle,
yes. I was looking over here on the notes. I was like, where is it? Versus Sertab's track, Everyway That I Can. So, man, looking forward to diving into this. Of course, we're going to have the videos for this here. John noted on this, two of Turkey's finest hours revolve around two of their most highly regarded female singing stars, one who came in third and the other who won the contest.
Wow, we're going to have a winner here. So we're going to start out with Dinle. Sebnem Paker, who was just 19 at the time, won the Turkish national final with this song. At 18, she sang for Turkey in the 1996 contest, placing 12th. So that probably helped her out. You already have experience. Yeah. Intervening in Eurovision musical styles, it prefigures the eventual ethnic turbo folk genre that came out of the Balkans and Eastern Europe in the 2000s. I'm just reading Johnson. I have no idea what any of that is. That means fusing traditional folk music with a modern sensibility, thus appealing to broader taste. He talks about the staging. The delegation decided to keep it simple, yet used a lot of crop shots to capture the imagination and directly communicate with the public. Sebnem is joined by Grup Etnik, comprising someone playing a ney?
A ney, I guess.
I should have let you have this paragraph. A baglama, the stringed instrument. Added is a traditional drum and keyboard, the player of which seems eager to take the party up a notch.
And lyrically, John notes that these are about someone sad and morose having lost in love and wondering about their erstwhile partner, saying that they still love them. Perhaps they are in the first stages of a separation. After this contest, she graduated and has worked as a music teacher since 2004. She's lived a modest life with her husband and children during this time. So I guess she got it all out of the way early.
Yeah, and now I don't think these videos are going to get blocked, but if they do, check out the Vimeo link below. We're not using the official Eurovision ones because those will get blocked, but John gave us some other ones. So once again, John, thanks. Crowd is lit.
It's a gargantuan stage, even by Eurovision standards. Couldn't wait for a distant ghost. You say you love me and you rolled your eyes. To stare at the empty skies. I thought it was over and you pass all that. Moving on is too fast, back to frame number one. Come on now.
Much more Eurovision.
Oh yeah, man. I'm getting those early 2000s vibes in the back. You're closer, oh so good. You make me feel just like I should. I know what you're thinking, good. Now this other world is over. Tell me what you see in other girls all around. Come on closer and tell me what you don't find here. Come on now. This came from. It came out of nowhere.
Yeah, I know. It's been pulled in every direction.
No, sir. Sertab, Every Way That I Can, coming in with this one. Obviously, I think the highlight here is the just kind of the choreography that we had. We had her up there with four other dancers, and you know, that I think added a bit of a kind of pizzazz to the performance here.
Yeah, it was much more performance art along with the voice, which is what we're talking about in the previous track with Dinle, where you didn't have that. You just had the instrumentation. Two vastly different, and I mean, I know this one won, so obviously it was well thought of. Yeah, and I think the performance part we're talking about, where they pull the...
That was tight. I didn't even know she had that in her costume.
Yeah, the material out, the sash, I don't know what you call it, you know, and then she eventually shook them all off and it fell down. Her voice is pretty good. I think it's not nearly as good as Shebnin's, but, you know, it's still good.
No, man, and I think that it was kind of cool, too, because she was kind of being, like you said, pulled in all directions while also trying to, you know, love the person she's talking about any way that she can and maybe keep the relationship alive in a sense. But I guess that'll take us now to our winner of this battle. I as much as I like the kind of performance and how it all went together for Every Way That I Can, I gotta go with Shebnem's track, Dinle. I just thought that the voice there was just fantastic, and the instrumentation was one of the better things that I've heard on Eurovision.
I have to echo your thoughts. It's nothing against Serta. I know that she won, so obviously, but
we're going against the grain.
Yeah, but definitely got to go with Sebnem Paker. I mean, like you said, it's one of the best Eurovision songs, if not the best I have heard. So yeah, great choices, John.
No, absolutely. Be sure to give John some love in the comments for suggesting this one. And of course, let us know your winner of this battle down in the comments below. And you can check out our other Eurovision battles as well. And we'll have that at the end screen, along with our Patreon page, which you can check out if you'd like to support the channel. Have us maybe do a song reaction or battle for you. And be sure to hit that big red subscribe button and that thumbs up.
We appreciate it.
And I guess, Dad, that'll do it from us today. And until next time, y'all, thanks so much for watching. Happy listening, and we will see you.